Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of Blockchain Central. Today we're going to give you a breakdown of the most important blockchain events of August. We have more interesting adoption news coming from China and from various industries, including a few new use cases for DLT. Let's get right into it. If you want to stay up to date with our content, be sure to click that subscribe button and hit that little bell to always get notified when we drop a new video. The first big piece of adoption news last month is still more of a rumor at this point. But if this prediction turns out to be true, it might actually be the first mainstream crypto adoption by a government. Judging by the current troubles that Facebook Libra is facing, an announcement that China's central bank is launching a state-backed cryptocurrency would shake up the entire financial landscape. As we all know, China has had a turbulent history with digital currencies accumulating in national bans on commercial crypto activities, ICOs, and mining. When these bans were announced, a suggestion was made that the country was working on an alternative solution that will ensure that the government retains full control of the market, something that would be impossible with a decentralized network. According to Paul Schultz, who previously worked as global head of financial strategy for China Construction Bank, the People's Bank of China will issue a centrally managed digital currency to the most trusted institutions, such as the Industrial and Commercial Bank of China, the Bank of China, and the Agricultural Bank of China. What's more, the consortium is also said to include two of the biggest Chinese tech companies, Tencent and Alibaba. Even though the technical specs have not yet been disclosed, the currency is said to be capable of achieving 300,000 transactions per second. That throughput would absolutely be crucial, considering China's traffic can reach a peak volume of 92,000 transactions per second. Judging by the network's speed and the priorities of the Chinese government, the centrally controlled assets will not be a distributed network and will probably only use selected elements of a blockchain architecture. As of September 4th, 2019, the banks have not confirmed or denied the reports. Another interesting area in which blockchain technologies are being implemented is, surprise, the production and sales of alcohol. The main DLT disruptor in the area of supply chain, VeChain, has announced a partnership with DIG aimed at curbing the illegal wine trade and wine counterfeiting business in China. The issue is serious, as it was reported that Chinese authorities seized a total of 65,000 counterfeit bottles of Penfolds worth around $4 million in recent years. VeChain uses a combination of NFC chips and non-fungible tokens to provide reliable, verified, and immutable information about each bottle. The customers can access the information by scanning the NFC chip, and the reliability of data is verified by an independent auditor. A similar initiative is being tested between Ernst & Young and WIV, an Oslo-based wine investment platform. The goal, again, is to guarantee that authenticity of rare wines by using non-fungible ERC-721 tokens. The partnership marks yet another step in using blockchains to turn new assets into reliable investment vehicles. According to Paul Brody, the global blockchain leader at Ernst & Young, getting tokenization right is an indispensable element of this process. Of course, additional security measures are taken to ensure that the token truly represents the wine in question. The tokens are linked to wine cases in secure and bonded warehouses. And when it comes to slightly less refined beverages, CoinDesk reported that Miller Lite has gamified their Know Your Beer marketing campaign with the help of DLT. Their technical partner is Vatom Labs, a marketing agency from Carbondale, Colorado, that specializes in audience activation experiences. As per the report, the participants can win a $5 prize that they can use to buy Miller Lite. The handling of prizes is said to be delivered through a tokenized platform linked with PayPal, and the technology is referred to by Vatom as smart media objects. We couldn't independently confirm this report, so please do your own research. When talking about regulatory news, we can't forget about Facebook's Libra. It seems like the initiative is facing more setbacks as EU's antitrust regulators are scrutinizing the project's data protection measures and looking into monopoly risk. Because the investigation included analyzing the current, already announced members of the Libra Association, it was said that a few companies started considering pulling out of the project, citing very harsh regulatory spotlight. These concerns, as reported by Financial Times, have not been viewed positively by Facebook itself, which, according to sources, is unhappy that the association members do not maintain a united front. While challenges seem to be mounting for Libra, it is important to note that the key crypto veterans such as Coinbase, Zappo, or Anchorage remain dedicated to the project. In other news, Volvo is reported to have used blockchain to track recycled cobalt used in their electric cars. The mineral is needed for the production of lithium-ion battery cathodes and plays a crucial role in the chemistry of high-performance cells. What is important, cobalt specifically has been included in the list of materials that are possibly linked to human rights abuses. These can include using child labor to extract the mineral in Africa. Amnesty International claims that the chance electric vehicle batteries are tainted with child labor or other abuses is unacceptably high. The initiative can help mitigate this serious issue by tracking cobalt from a Chinese recycling plant all the way to Volvo cars in Zhejiang over a period of 2 months. The project, that's powered by Oracle technology and operated by Circular, a London-based IT company, aims to bring full transparency and traceability to the cobalt industry. In the field of insurance, the industry giant AGCS is developing a full token-based ecosystem that uses blockchain to facilitate global insurance payments. According to the Alliance spokesperson, AGCS is further exploring blockchain technology to simplify and accelerate cross-border insurance payments for its corporate customers. CoinDesk additionally reported that the token will run on a proprietary blockchain built for by the blockchain company Agent. Telecommunication is yet another industry that is looking into adopting cryptocurrency payments. A1, one of Austria's largest telecommunication companies, is reportedly looking to allow its customers to pay in stores with a wide range of cryptos. The technical aspects of the project is delivered in collaboration with Salamantex, a payment provider that has worked alongside point-of-sale giant Ingenico to create their crypto-capable devices. The supported currencies include Dash, Ethereum, Litecoin, Stellar, and XRP. So, that's it for our summary of August events in the crypto and blockchain space. If you like this video, make sure to hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe to Blockchain Central to never miss a beat. Also, check out our blog, link in the description below. Before you go, please note that this content does neither represent financial, legal, or tax advice, nor is it supposed to be understood or interpreted as solicitation to buy or sell any securities, coins, or tokens. See you in the next one.